Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing Kreyn-Nicholson method problem number 2. Welcome back friends, let's have a look on the given problem. We need to solve by using Kreyn-Nicholson method. This is the condition, this is the equation given, and these are the boundary condition provided to us in two steps for a time. The first step is we need to compare this equation with the standard equation, that is dou square u upon dou x square minus a dou u by dou t equal to 0. If we compare, we'll get the value of a is equal to 1. Let's check the boundary condition. The first condition, u of x comma 0 equal to 0. By looking at the condition, we cannot say anything about x, but we can say about t, and the t value is 0. Let's check the second condition, u of 0 comma t, that means x is 0, can't say anything about t. From the third condition, it is u of 1 comma t, that means x is 1 and t, we can't say anything. Let's draw the table. X is going from 0 to 1. As discussed, in Kreyn-Nicholson, we're going to consider maximum phi intervals. Therefore, no option. We need to check. We need to take the value of h as 0.25. That will be 0.5, then will be 0.75. In two steps for a time, t is equal to 0. Friends, first of all, two steps does not mean t is equal to 0, 1 and 2, because it is 2 step 1 and 2. No. 2 steps, it depends upon the value of k. First of all, we need to find the value of k. K is ah square. This is the formula. Here, if you see, the value of a is 1. We'll get h square only. That is 0.25, because we assume the value of h is 0.25, which will be 1 by 16. K value, we got it as 1 by 16. In two steps of time, the first will be 1 by 16 and the next will be two steps, that is 2 by 16. This is the meaning of two steps. Let's check the other conditions given in the problem. Therefore, here it will be up to 2 by 16. That is two steps. If you see the condition, the first condition is u of x comma 0 equal to 0. That means x can vary, t is 0. X can be 0 or x can be 0.25. X can be 0.5, 0.75. And 1. For all these values, the solution is 0. T is 0, x can be anything, the answer is 0. That means this. Let's move on and let's check the next condition. The second condition given is u of 0 comma t equal to 0. Here friends, t can be 0 or t can be 1 or t can be 2. For all, it is 0. X is 0, t can be 0, 1, 2, the answer is 0. That means this. Because x is 0, t can be anything, the answer is 0. Let's check the last condition. The last condition is u of 1 comma t is equal to 2t. Here again, the x is fixed, t can be anything, let's take t as 0, let's take t as 1, and finally t as 2. Let's check for the second condition. If you see the second condition, it is u of 0 comma t equal to 0. That means here x value 0 fixed, t value can change. If you see this, t value is 0, 1 by 16 and 2 by 16. For 1 by 16 it is 0, as well as for 2 by 16 also it is 0. Therefore, let's check for the second condition. The second condition given in the problem is u of 0 comma t equal to 0. That means in this problem, only t will vary, x is fixed. If you see here, t is 0, 1 by 16 and 2 by 16, that we are going to consider. If it is 0, it can be 1 by 16 or it can be 2 by 16. Done with the second condition. If we fill in the table, we are talking about this. Let's move on, let's check the third condition. In the third condition, u of 1 comma t is equal to 2t. Here also, x is fixed, t can be 0, t can be 1 by 16 or t can be 2 by 16. If t is 0, then 0. 1 by 16, it is 2 into 1 by 16, that is 1 by 8. And 2 by 16, that means 2 into 2 by 16, that is 1 by 4. Let's fill this in the table. X is 1, t changing 0, 1 by 8 and 1 by 4. X is 1, 0, 1 by 8 and 1 by 4. We need to complete this table. These are the unknowns u1, u2, u3, u4, u5 and u6. These are the unknowns that we need to find it out. Let's start the solution. First of all, we'll find it out for u1 by Krang-Nicholson method. This is u1. That means u1 is equal to 1 upon 4. This side it is 0. This side 0. Here also 0 and u2. From this you can say 4u4. If you cross multiply, this is 4u1, u2. This 4 going this side multiplying minus u2. u2 will come this side equal to 0. This is equation number 1. Let's consider for u2 now. For u2, it will be this. That means u2 is equal to this, 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 and this. 1 upon 4, 0 plus 0 plus u1 plus u3. Let's simplify this. If we cross multiply, 4u2 is equal to u1 plus u3. Let me consider all this side, left hand side, that will be minus u1, u2 is already on left hand side, u3 also will go to the left hand side, minus u3 equal to 0. See, basically what I am trying to do is, I want equation in terms of u1, u2, u3 so that I can substitute in calci and get the result. Let's move on and let's try to find it out the third equation for u3, that is this, this, this and this. u3 is equal to 1 upon 4, 0 plus 0 plus u2 plus 1 upon 8. This 4 will go this side, cross multiply, that will become 4u3 equal to u2 plus 1 upon 8. Let's take u2 this side, minus u2 plus 4u3 equal to 1 upon 8. This is equation number 3. If we put 1, 2 and 3 in the calculator, we'll get the values as u1, u2, u3. u1 is coming out to be 0.0022, u2 will be 0.0089 and U3 will be 0.03348. We are done with the first step. We got the values of U1, U2, U3. What next? We need to find it out U4, U5 and U6. Let's move on. For U4, it will be this, this, this and this. This one, and this one. 1 upon 4. If we say this side it is 0, this side it is U2, 0 and U. Therefore, cross multiply 4U4 is equal to U2 plus U5. Now friends, we want equation in terms of U4, U5 and U6. This U2 is already known to us that we got here only. Therefore, it will be 4U4 minus U5 is equal to U2. Let us substitute the value of U2, which is 0.0089. This is equation number 4. I want 4, 5 and 6 equation to get the solution. Let's move on. Let's check the next equation. For U5, it will be this, this, this and this. U1, U3, U4, U6. Again, if you cross multiply, 4U5 is equal to U1 plus U3 plus U4 plus U6. Let's move the unknowns this side. First, it is U4. Yes, we do have U4. That side, that will become minus U4. U5 is already this side. U6 will go that side, will become minus U6. And on right hand side, we'll be left with the U1 and U3. U1, U3, we already got the values here. We just need to add the values of U1 and U3, that is 0.0022 and 0.03348. If we add, we'll get 0.03571. This is equation number 5. Finally, my aim is to find it out. The last equation, and that is U6. For U6, we'll take U2, 1 by 8, this and this. U2, 1 by 8, U5, 1 by 4. Again, 4 will be cross multiplied. We'll get 4U6 is equal to U2 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 4 plus U5. Let's take the unknown on left hand side. That means minus U5 plus 4U6. See this. This is known because we know the value of U2. We know 1 upon 8 and 1 by 4. We're going to add it and we'll get it as 0.3839. This is equation number 6. We got all the equations 4, 5 and 6. We need to put equation 4, 5 and 6 into calculator and we need to get the values of U4, U5 and U6. U4 value, if you put in calculator, you get as 0.01178. U5 value, you'll get it as 0.03822. And finally, 0.1080. We got all the values. Let's put these values in the final table to get the solution. X and T. X is 0.25, 0.5, 0.75 and 1. T values 0, 1 by 16, 2 by 16, this is 0, this is 0, this is 1 by 16, this is 2 by 16. Let's fill the values. U1, U2, U3, we already got it. Let me write it down. 0.0022, 0.0089. 0.03348 and U4, U5, U6 0.01178. U5 value is this 0.03822 and finally U6 value is 0.1080. we are done with the table. We got the value of u for different values of x and t. This problem, it is asked for two steps. We got it. In the next video, we'll discuss one more example. Thank you.